Science Underground with your host, Ainissa Ramirez.
This week, the mysterious number pi and its hidden uses. I'm Ainissa Ramirez, and this is
Science Underground.
Apple, blueberry, and 3.14. What do they have in common? They're all forms of pi. You might have heard of this mathematical number called pi, and you might know that it defines a circle by relating the circumference to the diameter. This might not seem like much to you, but circles are everywhere, so that means that pi is too. Not only are circles defined by pi, but also repeating cycles. That means that swinging pendulums for telling time, alternating current for the flow of electricity, and even satellite orbits for GPS all use pi. Besides being everywhere, pi's been around for a long time. There's even a mention of it in the Bible for building round things. However, back then, they used the number 3, but that wasn't exactly right. We know now that that 3 is followed by other numbers after the decimal point. That's one of the strange things about pi. It can't be written as a fraction. Mathematicians would call it irrational. For more on this, Mario Livio, an astronomer and best-selling author, explains.
You cannot write any fraction that will be equal to pi. Sometimes people use 22 over 7 as a number that kind of comes close to pi, and indeed it comes fairly close, but it is definitely not equal to pi.
Pi has some hidden uses too. Whenever you want to take the average of something and need to do statistics, then you're secretly using pi. Say you wanted to measure the heights of kids in a class. If you were to plot the heights of those kids, the shape of the curve would look like a bell. This is called a bell curve, or a normal distribution. The mathematical formula for the bell curve has pi in it. The bell curve doesn't look like a circle, but pi is inside of it. Pi is a mysterious number that touches so many parts of our lives without our knowing. But just like the apple and blueberry versions, the pi of 3.14 is pretty sweet. I'm Ainissa Ramirez, and this was
Science Underground.